Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with Thick Man Blood Money. If you enjoy this video, please write a letter to Santa and ask that he stop using dodgy reindeers to tow his sled and that he instead starts using majestic pelicans, as this would really help spread the good word of my channel. Today we are heading to a Christmas party in the Rocky Mountains to assassinate Lorne de Havilland, who is a self-professed playboy and owner of this luxurious estate, and Chad Bingham, who looks like a pretentious malacca who I'd love to just punch in the jaw. If you're wondering why the graphics look like they're from the Middle Ages, it's because the game basically is. But you guys have been complaining about a lack of thickness in my Hitman videos lately, and I assure you, this is the thickest mission of all time. In fact, this entire game is just really thick. I had to complete a few of the missions to unlock this one, and I went to a nightclub where every single female in there had a G-string showing. Imagine if a game like this released today. Gaming journalists would literally have brain aneurysms in disgust. What I'm trying to say is that can we get an HD 4K remaster ASAP for our research purposes? Anyway, back to the mission. I proceed to immediately get recorded by a security camera, and then I miss the elevator. Damn, I'm good at my job. Eventually, I do ride up with this guy who looks like me in real life when I try to grow a mustache. Honestly, the only thing more sketchy than my attempt at a beard is Prince Andrew at a sweet 16th birthday party. Statutory molestation accusations of the royal family aside, it's time to scope out our surroundings and locate the targets. I make my way into the main function space, and there are decorations, men in suits, and of course, scantily dressed women everywhere. Jokes aside, this game really is so sexist, it's shameful. I mean, look around and observe the difference between what the men are wearing and what the women are wearing. The women get to wear comfortable swimwear, but the men have to wear rigid formal suits, like come on, it's a party. There are jacuzzis, but apparently the men are banned from having a nice little splash so they can look pretty for the girls. Then I kid you not, this woman says to me,
"Who wouldn't mind unwrapping you under the tree?"
You wouldn't mind unwrapping me under the tree? Are you implying that I'm an inanimate object? Did you just objectify me? I'm actually shaking with oppressed white male anger right now. Wow, I'm not even sure who I'm making fun of at the moment, so let's just try to blend into the party. When conducting reconnaissance, the trick is to be a presence that no one is aware of. We're just one of the guests enjoying the festive season. So I make my way fully clothed into the hot tub where Chad Bingham is sitting, and I proceed to start pirouetting like a champ. Girls love it when I spin like this, as it's not only stunning, it's also brave. Now that I've clearly established some rapport, I'll be able to move around more freely. I find an unlocked door and make my way inside. You might also be asking yourself, what's in the briefcase, Jeff? Well, I've brought along a silenced sniper rifle with armor-piercing rounds. Practical? No, not at all. I find a secret passageway under a waterfall. Water not only hydrates you, it can also be a door. What an exceptional liquid. I instantly get caught by some security guards, and they kindly ask me to please leave the VIP area. Professional assassin, by the way. We need a fresh strategy, and fortunately I do have a little ace up my sleeve. I head back to the elevator and climb on top of it, and then wait for a guard to take a ride. Then it's simply a matter of strangling him with my fiber wire. Obviously, it's not ideal for our mission rating to kill a reasonably innocent guard who probably has a young, loving, dependent family. But more importantly, doesn't Thick Man look like a little snack in his Christmas hat? Anyway, with this disguise, I have access to the staff areas, and then I spot a familiar-looking figure. It's Santa Claus, and he is heavily drinking. I consider killing him, but then decide I won't, as I want my videos to have a less sadistic feel about them. I don't know what's behind this door, but it looks important. Probably where Lorne de Havilland is hanging out at his adult film studio. Unfortunately, Bill and Bob here aren't going to let me through, so as a joke, I open the door. And clearly, lacking a sophisticated sense of humor, they gun me down in cold blood. At least I'll leave a beautiful corpse, I guess. So take two, and this time I make my way upstairs and find the guards' headquarters. Might as well take the security tape here so they don't have my face on record. But he turns around too fast and I get gunned down again. Oh my god. So take three back at the guards' headquarters, but this time I'm going to play it smart. I throw a coin, but it just hits the door. Thick man, that can't really be how you throw, big fella. What, your dad didn't teach you how to toss a ball? Wow, shit. Statistically, 25% of my audience felt that one a little too hard. Anyway, somehow this guy sees me again, and I just shoot him until I eventually die. Boy oh boy, I need to reevaluate my life. This isn't even on the hardest difficulty. On the map, I notice a little room that I haven't explored yet, so let's check it out. Oh good, here we go. There's a beautiful lass beckoning me into the room with her finger. The thick man needs this, you know. He just died 3 times in about 10 minutes, and multiple deaths can really get a man down. She then pulls out a knife, and my reaction time is not impressive. I then get stabbed in the neck by Santa's sexy little helper, and not in the fun, kinky way. I swear no matter what I do at the moment, I die. I forgot how much harder these older Hitman games are than the new ones. That's an excuse, I hope you bought it. So obviously I had to go and get revenge on her, but now it's time to kill one of these actual targets. I almost completely forgot about them. I find a sneaky way to climb over to the staff section of the building. This is unbelievably dangerous with the ice and the thin ledges. Also, I'm already wearing a staff disguise, so I probably could have just walked in. Geez, this really isn't my best performance, so I drink a Yakult in real life, which is a great source of probiotics, and get ready to step things up. I bait an elite guard outside and then inject him with a sedative. I also put a hit of gonorrhea in the syringe, so have fun with that. With his suit, I can now maybe go more places. Speaking of places, where am I? I feel like I'm about to get mugged, sexually assaulted, and murdered all at once. How is this the staff quarters? The staff should really band together and request a refurbishment. Remember, when employees all work together, that's how change happens. I find a waiter taking a shower, and I stand uncomfortably close to him. He proceeds to just make intense eye contact with me, probably undressing me with his eyes, the perv. I proceed to actually undress and change into his waiter disguise. No point rock climbing again, so this time I take the staff lift. As I try to leave, there are literal laser beams blocking the way. What, Lorne de Havilland can afford a laser security system but can't buy a ping pong table for the staff rec room? This guy really does deserve to die. So I make my way back to the main bar and have a chat to the waiter. He drops an aphrodisiac, which I pick up. He also does a mime impression, which is definitely a mime impression and not a glitch. For those of you who don't know what an aphrodisiac is, it's basically a substance that increases a person's sexual desire. For example, strawberries are a natural aphrodisiac. So the next time your uncle starts feeding you strawberries, you might want to find an excuse to leave. So here's the play, right? The waiter continually brings Chad martinis, and so I need to get some poison into one of those martinis, which will make for an easy clap. I go and change back into my elite guard disguise because it gives me more freedom. I then wait for the martini to be refilled, but instead of adding the poison, I panic and add the aphrodisiac I picked up. Not ideal, but at least I'm not being shot again for opening a door. The waiter then grabs the drink and puts it down for Chad, which he sculls all in one go. I'm sure you're used to swallowing fast, hey Chad. Haha, you know it's good content when I start rehashing jokes I heard at school back when I was 13 years old. Anyway, this girl asks if he'd like to have a lap dance, and he says yes. Funny that he needed an aphrodisiac to say yes. Look kids, basically steroid abuse is no joke. If you do steroids, you'll become angry, your balls will shrink, and in some of the nastier cases, you'll turn into a Russian. So Chad and his friend have their fun, and afterwards he makes his way down to the balcony. Fortunately for me, he's not a skeptical guy and doesn't find it weird that I've been ghosting him, so I take him down with a lethal syringe. I'm getting really into psychological warfare too, so I dump the body into the ocean. Imagine the distress when they never find him and never know what truly happened to young Chad. Lol, got him. One target down, one to go. Yet another oversight by me, but the hot tub has a glass floor, and everyone saw me kill him, so yeah. We have a small situation on our hands, and basically every guard in the vicinity is trying to kill me. Looks like it's back to the Santa hat disguise, because in this world, putting on a cheerful hat is like undertaking facial reconstruction surgery. Time to find the big boss himself. I head back to the security room and take the videotape with no problem. Not sure how I struggled with this so much the first time, or times rather. I then pick the lock when no one is watching, and bam, we now have access to the adult film studio. You know when you're on a diet and you have a pizza, and then a packet of chips and maybe a piece of chocolate cake, and then you're like, you know what, I'm just going to eat whatever I like, I'm too far gone. Well, I feel like I'm at that point with killing innocent people at the moment. At this stage, we might as well go all in. I locate Lorne, and he's got a little dog. I'm not going to harm the dog, as in my Witcher video I killed a cat and I actually felt bad. It's weird how you can slaughter just about anyone, but as soon as fluffy animals come into play, you feel guilty. I decide I'll wait up on the catwalk with my sniper rifle and take him down from above and then wait for the heat to die down so I can just sneak away without anyone realizing it was little old Thick Man. It's the perfect plan, except apparently I'm actually in plain sight up here, and everyone starts freaking out when they see me lurking with a sniper rifle. Activate Operation YY Fakey Fakey Trickshot Claymore Switch 720-420 Blazing Quickscope or baby a triple protocol. This strategy is a last resort, but I've been afforded little choice, and so I start taking down any potential threat in the vicinity. I head out to Lorne's suite, and then take the big girl down with a clean no-scope. Contract complete, we've done it. I make my way up to the helipad to escape, at this point treating the game more like it's Doom, rather than an intricate stealth experience. They don't really do ratings in this game like they do in the new ones, but if I had to guess, I'd say I got the rating really shit out of 5 stars. Thanks for watching, you absolute legends, and a massive thanks to those who support the channel on Patreon. Until next time, and as always, stay classy.